behind the Viral Pool Star, brought to you by William Hill, the proud sponsor of the World Darts Championship. A great couple of weeks for Phil Taylor as he defended with the help of Adrian Lewis the World Cup of Darts in Germany, followed up by the Australian Darts Open victory, 6-4 in the final against bully boy Michael Smith, to run the roar over what's been happening in the PDC in the last couple of weeks. We're joined by no other than a 5-time champion of the world, Eric Bristow. How are you doing, Eric?
All right, mate, how are you?
It's all good. We mentioned a couple of weeks ago, last time we spoke, about Michael van Gerwen looked imperious and looked like he could go the whole year without getting beat. Then all of a sudden, he gets beat in Dubai by Gary. Then it didn't work out in the World Cup and he didn't win this weekend. What's going on for the Green Machine?
Dubai should have won, and that's what I think that started to rot, really. The World Cup, well, Dubai should have won in his doubles against Gary, but to give Gary his due, he's stuck in there. The World Cup pairs, what a difference a year makes. He walked off last year and said, I'm playing on my own because Barney can win again in the final, like singles. And this year, he didn't win a game in the final. So, and then, as you say, last weekend in Austria, he lost in the final against Smithy, didn't he? No, he lost in the last eight Carl Anderson.
Carl Anderson, who actually was doing great. See, of course, he beat Michael, and then he took Phil all the way, didn't he? Took him to the deciding leg. He's got a good game, Carl Anderson, hasn't he? He's dangerous.
Yeah, he looked like a frightened chicken the second game in the World Pairs. He looked terrible. He didn't look right at all. And then Whitlock pulled him through. Whitlock played brilliant in the Pairs to get him through. But then the next day, he played lovely, didn't he? He beat Barney and he was enjoying his game again. So, and that gives you a bit of confidence then to go to the next tournament, which proved in Austria. I mean, he beat Michael van Gerwen, lost 6-5 to Taylor, and should have beat Taylor. So, we've always known he's been a good player, but there's a lot of good players out there. It's just they don't do it. And then once they do start doing it once, they believe then. So, we might see a different Carl Anderson the rest of the year then.
Yeah, that would be great. And as I say, not the worst a few days for Phil the Power Taylor. My word, as they collect regaining the World Cup and, of course, winning in Austria. So, obviously, the big one's coming up. Well, the match play's coming up, the next big one. I mean, obviously, they've got World Series between now and then. But that's a massive tournament, isn't it, for Phil? He hasn't won a major for a while. And if
this is a big one. This is the first big one of the year, Blackpool. I mean, we've had the Premier League for 16, 17 weeks. We've had all these other tournaments. They're going to be travelling around Australia, New Zealand, playing these other tournaments, and there's only eight of them invited. But the real big one is the first big one of the year is Blackpool. So then we'll see how everybody's playing then.
Yeah.
And Phil likes that format. You know, best of 19 legs, first round. It's great. You've got no excuses there. Yeah.
Would that have been a sort of toilet? Toilet?
Well, if you play tournament, you're out first round.
Would that have been the sort of tournament you would have loved up there in the summer, Eric? Oh.
Well, when I was at Pomp, yeah, I played there a few times. I never won there, but you've got no excuse over 19 legs. You know, you can miss a couple of darts at a double, one or two legs. You can't blame it on that. If you lose 10 legs, you didn't deserve to win, did you?
No, that's true. No, yeah, that's right. You're not a mug if you can win that sort of tournament, are you? That's for sure.
I think it's looking good because there's a lot of players at the moment that are picking up. Even Whitlock's playing better at the moment. So they're going to be dangerous floaters. And these players who might not win the tournament, but Whitlock might knock a big seed out and then go out the next round. But it opens it up for people, doesn't it? I mean, you know, when you get through, you're one of the top four or eight seeds and you get through, you want all these other Birch players to do you a favour and knock some of the big boys out.
Yeah,
you don't want to be playing them all yourself. It's far better to just play one of them in the final instead of playing top eight in the last eight and a semi-final and a final, because it takes a bit out of you. So, you know, I can't see in these major tournaments now ever there being the top eight seeds in the last eight.
Really? No, that's good for the game, isn't it? I mean, I expect the sponsors and everyone wants to see the top eight. You know, one plays eight and two plays seven, but it's not ideal for the game, is it? We want to see the rags, as we call it, coming through.
Too many good players now. There's too many good players. I mean, so yeah, to get in the top 32, you've got to be a good player. You know, like 4 or 5 years ago, you had to be a very good player to get in the top 16. Now, you've got to be a very good player to, you know, get in the top 32. And now people are sliding out now. But, you know, there's a lot of new faces coming in each year, three or four new ones coming through. So it was good for the game.
Yeah, very much so. Talking about the game, of course, at the weekend with Dan and Butlins, we rolling back the years there, Eric. And then, of course, we've already spoke about this. January next year, we're up at Warners with the Legends. That'll be fun as well, won't it?
Well, that's going to be a great weekend. You've got 10 old fogies there, isn't you? So, I mean, that's going to be a great 3 days at Warners. So yeah, we're all looking forward to that. Yeah. We'll all be practising. As soon as the Worlds is finished, I'll be on the Dartmoor practising with Warners.
Yeah, brilliant. And as far as the football goes, I know you follow a bit of football. Anything you fancy? I like the idea of Germany. I think they're always strong and world champions. Who are you looking at?
They always do the job, Germany, don't they? They get it done. We have hiccups all the time. You know, we should win and we don't win. And that's the story of England, isn't it?
Yeah.
Big game for England-Wales, I think.
Yeah.
That's a big game for us. I think we'll be all right. I think we'll pull through that. We'll get through the group no matter what anyway.
Yeah.
Even if we come third in that group, as long as we win the last game. So we've 4 points to get through.
Yeah.
But, yeah, we should have won the first game. No one's impressed me at the moment. I mean, France were lucky in the end.
Yeah.
Germany, all right, they look strong and whatever. Spain played all right, but they struggled and left it late. So, and they haven't really got a striker. They've got a lot of people to score, but they haven't got a main striker. So,
yeah.
We'll see. I mean, there's going to be a shock.
Yeah.
But we're not one of them.
No, that's it. I mean, it's an amazing tournament. When I think of a few years ago, when Denmark didn't qualify, got put in because of the issues in Yugoslavia, they win the tournament. A few years later, Greece win the tournament. That's
Greece was the one, wasn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, unbelievable.
It's like darts. They're all good players. They're all good teams. They win a game, they start believing in each other. And the whole idea about that is they've got to play as a team. It's not going to all be big individuals. You know, that's what I like about Wales and I like about Irish teams. And even though Scotland are not there, they always play as a team. We don't never seem to have that camaraderie. You know what I mean? I don't know what it is. They all think they're pop stars, that's a lot, you know what I mean?
What a great, great way to end it. Eric, thank you so much for your time. I look forward to seeing you at the weekend at Butlins.
I'm down to Blackpool now, doing some filming for the promotion. Me and Mardell doing some filming on the pier at 9 o'clock tomorrow morning.
Really? For the World Match Play, eh?
Yes.
Oh, say hello to Wayne from us. Brilliant. Can't wait.
Where's the draw for that?
Where?
When?
When is the draw? I believe that's after the seedings from the next Pro Tour, isn't it? So whenever... Yeah, so, and then we know, because that's 1 versus 32, isn't it?
I don't know if it's 16 or 8 seeds yeah. Pulled out. I don't think it's 1 v 32.
No, sorry, top, yeah, 1-16 in the second round, and the other, because it's all, then the next 16 in the Pro Tour Order of Merit, isn't it? So, that...
No, it's all, Josh Payne, new young's going to be there, so, Big step in his career, see how he does.
Yeah, that is great. And having the seedings like that, the fact that they will be playing somebody from the Pro Tour, you know, they're not next 16 in the Pro Tour, but that means those players are playing well, doesn't it? They're there for a reason. So,
top 16 in form.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Great stuff, Eric. Thank you very much for your time.
Cheers, Andy, pal.
All the best. Cheers, mate.
Bye.
Great to catch up there with the Crafty Cockney, of course, Eric Bristow. Don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, you can subscribe to our YouTube channel. It's free. Like our Facebook page and follow us on Twitter and join us next week on more Behind the Bar with Paul Starr, brought to you by William Hill, the proud sponsor of the World Darts Championship. We'll see you then.